Coach, what did you like about Brittany McQuaid tonight? She didn't really get on the scoreboard per se, but I thought she was very smart in the post and really sort of showed her maturity level of passing out and setting up ball reversals. Did you see a similar thing?
6 assists, 1 turnovers, no panic against the double team. Brittany's been having some monster games for us, so now the emphasis went back in on the inside, and that created everything around her on the outside. Cammie had a career night, I believe, with 17 points. Fee hit for 15, Jazz hit for 17. So teams are going to have to pick their poison where they want to go to stop us. And Brittany did a great job with the assist, the turnovers, and getting everybody else and the ball, and remained really poised against the double team. So it made us go.
What would a perfect conference regular season mean for the program?
Well, it's a tremendous accomplishment, you know. Winning every game at home, but we know we have a lot more to go ahead of us. But it is to get to 25 wins, you know, 20 special, 25 is pretty impressive. And, you know, staying undefeated on our home floor is a big deal because we put ourselves in a position to stay here throughout the playoffs. So home's been good for us and we want to stay home. So that's the biggest factor right now.
Lately, you've seen the team fall behind early in the game and start trailing at halftime. Tonight was the opposite. Really came out on fire and led by, at halftime. Did you change anything with the team, especially coming out of the game against Sacred Heart, one of the closest games of the season?
No, we didn't change a single thing. We just wanted to make sure, we wanted to guard against the letdown of such a big win and wrapping up the regular season. And we weren't flat at all. We came out, we played really well, we shot the ball really well. It was great to see Sam Guastella back in, hit some shots as well to build up. I believe it was a 14-point lead or a 16-point lead at halftime. Still come out, extend, and get to 20, and then we missed 3 straight front ends of 1-on-1s, and we didn't get back on our defensive transition to allow them to get a little life.
Coach, you have the wonderful tragedy of having to figure out how to split up minutes between a team that's incredibly deep off the bench. What's that like for you to be able to turn to a second unit and say, okay, just go play and have them play up to the level of the first unit?
Well, again, I think we saw this experiment born over in Italy when we were able to just rotate all our players in. We wanted them to give an experience of playing, and we realized that this is something that we may be able to be successful with. And we don't see it as first or second. It's, you know, been nicknamed the gold rush. So the fact that we have so many inches at certain spots has gotten us to 25 wins against 2 losses. And we just have a lot of answers if it's not going well for one particular person. And that's why we really have had the success, because it's not one single person that's got to come in and shoulder the load. But it's really nice to see us handle these closer situations these last couple of games, because we hadn't been in them, and really stayed poised and going forward. That's only going to benefit us.
We had to get a score. They were, you know, the momentum was on their side. I knew that I didn't have the open shot, so, you know, I looked around and saw Cammie. I knew she could hit it, so I threw it out to her, and her hitting that was, like, really big, and I think that was a turning point for us at the end of the game, so.
I saw also another play, which to me I thought was one of the big turning points of the game. You got away on a breakaway, scored a point, I think I forgot, you get guys back up by like 11 or something like that. Take us through that play.
I just saw that we got the steal. I knew I had to get out. I mean, if it was wide open, I knew I was going to make it. So I just made sure, took my time, went up, and we went up by 11. And then our biggest problem tonight was defending, so we just got to get into practice and focus on, you know, the details and the little things. I think going from Monday, Wednesday, Saturday, we played about 6 or 7 games in 13 days. So we haven't been able to focus on the details as much as we should be. So I think now that we're back on our regular schedule, I think that'll be very important for us.
You mentioned the defense sort of lacking tonight, and still 24 steals as a team.
Yeah.
But what was it, in your opinion, that you felt that as a team you could sort of clean up a little bit?
Transition defense, getting back. You know, our 1 and 2, we just have to focus on getting back right away instead of staying up, because we're so used to being in 55, which is full court, man-to-man. So we just have to focus on the little things that our coach is telling us, because in the long run, it's really going to be the biggest difference. So.
I'm having a blast down here. Back up to you. Peace.
Hey, Quinnipiac Bobcat fans. This is Billy Mecca from the Bobcat Sports Network. Please join us this season at the TD Bank Sports Center for some excellent men's and women's basketball and ice hockey games. The TD Bank Sports Center is the best facility in college athletics as it features family-friendly seating, prices, dates, and times. Please call area code 203-582-3905 or visit QuinnipiacBobcats.com to order your tickets now. Go Bobcats! Peace!